God, why don't we stand on our feet and let's worship the Lord together? God bless you guys. Here we go.
I'm running for your heart, I'm running for your heart.
know, last week we celebrated Mother's Day, and just a few weeks here we'll celebrate Father's Day. And as I'm thinking about the Father and how good He is. He's a good Father. You know what's so amazing about this Father that we know and serve in our Lord and our God is that even when we failed Him, even when we failed Him, even when we've done our own way, He never, ever, ever has stopped loving us and demonstrating and showing us His immense, incredible, awesome, wonderful love. He's a good, good Father. Let's worship. Partake of communion. Jesus said, do this in remembrance of me. You know, if my job, we do something at my job that helps us remember God's faithfulness. We've got these long glass jars, and we've got in them these black rocks. They're the rocks, on the rocks. Whenever we see God do something that was absolutely, we prayed about something and God just brought us through and brought a miracle our way, we write on the rocks. We'll write on the rocks to remember what God did. This week we ran into a situation that on Tuesday morning, right, we got to work and basically we're getting ready to do an event this coming weekend in Anaheim, California. Basically, we got some news that was devastating. The hotel where we're having this conference canceled the event. And it was a bad situation. We didn't know what we were going to do. We tried calling them, and they were pretty adamant that it was done. They weren't going to do the event, and there had been some problems that couldn't be worked through. And the only thing I needed to do, I stopped, you know, I asked our CEO, hey, can we just stop and pray? And I says, why don't we all just ask anybody that you know, just ask them to pray. And I put on Facebook, friends and family, you know, we're in a situation that looks impossible. We need prayer right now for our ministry, right now. And Joyce knows this. I think, was it like over 100 people who actually were praying? Some of them wrote prayers right then and there. And then had almost 200 likes, people that were just staying in agreement with it. But we knew that they were praying. And I mean, and then as a staff, we got together. We prayed right then and there. Can I tell you something? God totally turned the thing around. I mean, just like that. It was absolutely astounding. Within 2 hours, we were on again. Within 2 hours, our registrations had more than doubled for that event, which they were struggling. And now, I mean, they've more than quadrupled. It's just absolutely amazing. I think there's like 5 or 6 times more registration right now than we had on Tuesday, which was phenomenal. The whole thing turned around. So you know what we're doing? We're riding on a rock, what God did. You know why we do that again? Because so oftentimes you and I, we forget that God saw us through at one point. We forget what he did. And then when another trouble or problem comes, we're like, Lord, where are you? Can I tell you something? He's a good God. And he's a faithful God. Amen. Amen. So right now, if you're facing something and you need a breakthrough, you know why Jesus said, do this in remembrance of me, speaking of communion? Because we remember that he bled and died for us. We remember that his body was broken for us. We never want to forget, because we never want to forget his immense, incredible love for us. And he loves you and wants to see you through and give you the breakthrough that you need. And it may not come today. It may not come tomorrow. It may not even come next week, but it's coming. Because God loves you, he's going to see you through. Let's pray. Why don't you lift up that need? Whatever it is that's hindering you from just trusting him, just lift it up to him right now. Cast your care upon him right now, Father, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that we know that you're a good God, a merciful God, a loving God, a forgiving God. Lord, thank you. Thank you, Lord, that in the past you had seen us through. When you went to the cross and gave your life and died, you showed mankind how much you loved us and what we meant to you. And so, Lord, how could we ever forget that, Lord, you'll not abandon us. You'll not leave us alone. And that, Lord, you are faithful to your word. And, Lord, you will see us through. So right now, that one who needs a touch, touch them. That one who needs comfort, Lord, wrap your arms of love around them and comfort them. That one who is in the midst of a storm needs to know your peace. Give them peace. Give strength to that one who's weak. that one who's just tired, just doesn't seem like they've got the strength to keep on going, gird them up, strengthen them, Lord. Lord, fill that one with joy who's been downhearted. Lord, right now, do a mighty work in this place, in the hearts and lives of every single man, woman, boy, and girl. Lord, pour out your grace, your forgiveness for all those times that we've blown it. And thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your love. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Communion stations are open right now. Let's worship Him as we partake of communion. You're welcome to do that right now. Sunday morning be a time of worship, and let our lives worship you. I pray that we can bring you honor and glory and praise and worship, because, Lord, none deserves it more than you. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. Now, Lord, prepare our hearts for your word. Let your word just have its way to help us to become more and more and more like you. Use Pastor Jeff, anoint him with your spirit, Lord, that as he speaks, Lord, our hearts, Lord, will come alive with the life-giving power of your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you guys. You may be seated. Take a look at this.
So, Sonny, talk to us. What has Jesus been doing in your life to lead you to this point, to where you want to commit the rest of your life to Christ in baptism?
It all started, gosh, 40 years ago. I was fresh out of the Vietnam War, living in the jungle, fighting for my life. And when I left Vietnam in 69, December 1969, I was baptized January of 1970. But I wasn't explained what baptism was really all about. I was baptized, got up and said, all right, and went on. I didn't study the Bible. I didn't do anything. The only thing that I really did up until 2008 was talk to the Lord and say thank you and thank you for my life, and that was it. And when 1992 came around, I started having these nightmares, drinking else, PTSD they call it. I went into being a drunk for 20 years. But all through that 20 years, I still prayed to God and said thank you for today. And I always had the Lord Jesus and the blessing following him. Until 2008, I started reading the Bible. Started finding out who Jesus really is. And the blessings there is that I found out that he was taking care of me all the way back. He was carrying me. You ever seen that picture of the sand? He was carrying me through all of that. And he has a reason for what he did. And I'm waiting for him. He's preparing me to do what he wants me to do for him, and he's preparing me for that. And this is one of the biggest steps of them all. Thank you.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we're honored today, Sonny, to baptize you into Christ Jesus. As you die to your old life, living for yourself, as you bury that old life, and are raised to a new life in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Just as I am without one thing, but that thy blood was shed for me, and that thou didst come to thee, O Lamb of God. As I am, though tossed about, Just as your word is pierced into the dividing asunder of soul and spirit within us, Lord, help us to live according to your word, to walk in obedience to you, to be 110% sold out to Jesus, so that, Lord, we can influence our families and the world around us for your glory's sake, for your kingdom's sake, for righteousness' sake. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Amen. God bless you guys. Hey, go and make it a great week in the name of the Lord. Go make it, go make an influence upon the world for his glory. All right? Here we go.
Oh, Jesus, take all.